So here's a view of DC1 that you haven't seen in a long time. Over the course of the last week, all the CNC machines have gone, all the wiring's been disconnected, a lot of the posters and the branding have come down, and everything to do with our manufacturing capacity and capability has now been moved over to PC1, ready for installation at the new site. Let's head over there and I'll show you what we've been building for you. So from the gloom of DC1 being taken to pieces bit by bit after 2.5 years or so, to the excitement of PC1 being built from nothing into our very first production facility. Many of you will remember what was involved in getting the CNC machines installed in the first place, the sheer logistical effort that goes into getting the machines to site, getting them located, getting them built. We've had to go through all of what we went through previously, but this time 10 times the scale with all of the equipment that we've now got. So the whole of DC1 has been disassembled over the course of really the last week or so. We've had something like 10 or 15 lorry loads of equipment brought over to PC1 here, and now we start the painstaking job of putting it all back together before we can build the various structures in PC1 around the key equipment. So that's really been the main focus of the last week or so. Let's go down and I'll show you some of the new equipment we've got installed here at PC1. So one of the first things that's starting to take shape now is the new gantry mill that we'll be using to manufacture all of the composite tools, all of the composite patterns, doing some of the direct second stage machining on each of the fuselages and various other things as well. It's absolutely massive. Come and have a look at this. So unlike the last gantry mill that was just opened, this gantry mill comes with a complete enclosure so we can contain all of the dust and debris that's produced by machining within this environment, and then it's extracted outside into bales and pallets. As you can see, the bed on this one is about twice the size of the bed on the old machine. We've got much greater height underneath the gantry itself, and we can produce essentially whole sides of the fuselage in a single piece in here. But much more importantly than that, because it's a modern machine and it's reliable, we can run this thing 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, and it'll do that reliably. The other thing to note about this, on the app, there was a question the other day about how many fuselages can you produce on this. Remember that the main job of this machine is making the patterns and the molds that we make the fuselages from, not making the fuselages itself. This will at first and may in practice be used to do some second stage machining, but that is really just anywhere from half an hour to an hour's worth of machining per fuselage. So it could do anywhere between 40 and 80 a week by the time you consider changeover. So it's not going to be a capacity limitation at all. Let's go and have a look at where the machine shop's going to go. So this is all still very much under construction. The 2 5-axes have now been moved over here from DC1. The 3-axis and the larger of the lathes are in position. We've got the small lathe that we use for gear and bearing production just here, and then the grinder that you're familiar with seeing over at DC1. All of these are now in situ. I think pretty much all of them have been tied down to their machine bases, and then we're essentially getting them hooked up to power and control and air so that they're operational. Then we have to pause for a moment while we build the mezzanine floor over this entire area so that the machine shop itself becomes enclosed and then temperature controlled, and that then gives us the environment where once the machines have settled, we can do the laser alignment and get all of those tight tolerances back, and then we can start making precision components again. So just to give you an idea of the scale of the undertaking for each one of these machines, so the machine itself has to be planted on a machine foundation and securely tied to the ground. It has to have power that you've seen us routing around the factory. It has to have compressed air to feed the tool changer so that it can rapidly change tools while it's in production. We have to extract dust, we have to extract coolant vapor out of the machining cavity so that we don't end up with an explosive atmosphere. So all of these metal ducts that you can see here have got to be connected to our dust, vapor extraction system to stop the machining mist from forming in the machine shop. And then on top of that, we also then need to deal with the swarf extraction. So all of the swarf and the cuttings from the material that we remove off the parts then have to be conveyed away from the machine so it doesn't clog the machine, and then again into bins and hoppers and silos ready to be processed for recycling. So every single one of these machines has to have that set up, and what we're trying to do here is do that in a much more intelligent way than we did at DC1, so that we can scale easily then into volume production in the future. So we're just starting to put the tool room back together. If you remember at DC1, we had some non-automated machines as well that are used for fettling little bits of test rig and making corrections and modifications to things without recourse to complex CNC programs. So these machines have all been plonked in the right places, and then we build our tool room around here. In addition to the basic tool room, we're also now building a full fabrication facility to do all of the precision fabrications in super alloys and other materials for things like the combustor casing, the combustor itself, some of the engine casings, the firewall for the aircraft, and various other bits and pieces that we need. That's going to go right behind us just here. So the wire eroder is now situated in its new position here at the edge of the machine shop at PC1. This is the machine that we use to cut the fir trees in the turbine discs. We use it to create the shells for bearing races and a whole host of other intricate cutting and machining operations. This one's about to get wired in and should be operational within the next couple of weeks. So a lot of things at the moment are hanging on the production of the mezzanine floor area, which acts as an environmental chamber for the machine shop, some extra floor space for us upstairs, and a lot of the other production offices and things are built off the side of that. So we start construction of that basically as soon as the CNC machines are in. But as a temporary measure, the production staff are all out here on the shop floor at the moment until they get their new offices built around them. So in addition to the machine shop, obviously we've just started marking out a lot of the areas where we're creating controlled environments for laminating, for trimming, for all of the pattern making and block up, all the stuff that creates dust that we've got to keep away from the precision engineering. In addition to that, we've just started building our in-house paint booth. So this is where all of the prototype and then the early production HX50s are going to be painted. And right next to it, the curing oven that you've seen before in DC2 is going to be constructed shortly. All of this now will have proper extraction and centralized power and control that's all plumbed in to the manufacturing control system. So I don't know if you can make out this area that we've got marked out on the floor down here, but this whole area here is the new laminating shop. So we'll be building a clean room in this whole area here, which is where all of the airworthy airframes for the test program will be produced. So this is a temperature controlled, dust-free environment that makes sure that we don't get any debris or contamination in the laminates when we're building flight critical components. So the blades will be built in here, the airframes will be built in here, the crashworthy seats will be built in here. Anything that requires composites with high structural integrity will be built in this new controlled environment that we'll be constructing shortly. So it's big and it's really complicated, but PC1 is now coming together. You can see our massive new gantry mill is getting closer to being operational by the day. Within the next few weeks, we'll be taking test cuts on that and getting ourselves ready to produce the next batch of composite tools. The machine shop is now not a million miles away from being recommissioned and enabling us to build the last of the components for the very first GT50 engine.